How do I remove myself from a machine? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. The scenario is this. You're ending a long and successful relationship with your employer. Or maybe it's a not-so-long or not-so-successful one. While you're there, you could use your work computer to check your personal email, use an instant messaging client, check in on Facebook, even surf the web for non-work-related things, all within reason, no doubt. Now, on your way out the door, you'd like to make sure that your personal account information isn't left behind. Perhaps you'd like to clean up a few other traces of your activities as well. Well, before we go further, I gotta caution you. There is simply no easy way to ensure that all traces have been completely and irrevocably removed. The only way to do that on a machine is to reformat the machine you're leaving behind, taking care to erase absolutely everything on it. Now, I'm going to assume that since this is a company machine, you're not allowed to do that. Even if you were, had your organization installed spyware or been monitoring your network activity, both of which are allowed in many workplaces, the traces you might want to erase might not even be on your machine anymore. The steps here will keep honest people honest, making it difficult but not necessarily impossible to recover some of your information. Should someone have enough interest and resources, it's possible to recover quite a bit of information that's supposedly been deleted. It's not always easy, not always cheap, but it can be possible. So, before you ever use someone else's computer, even quote-unquote your computer at work, be aware you will leave a trail and behave accordingly. Instant messaging software seems to be a particularly convenient and not terribly intrusive way to stay in touch with friends and family and colleagues and even coworkers. Recent years have seen the rise of dedicated tools like Slack, specifically designed to enable workplace communication. There are several things you'll want to work with before you leave. Message history. Make sure it's turned off and deleted. Auto login. Make sure that this is turned off. Remove your account. This one's a little less obvious, but even without auto login selected, your account may still be listed as an option or remembered for whatever messaging platform you use. Look for ways to delete that if you can. Change your password. Honestly, this is just good practice. Do it from a different machine, such as your own at home, where you know that your activity isn't being monitored. Exactly how you do each of those things and whether or not they even apply, of course, will vary depending on which specific program you've been using. Web browsers. In an effort to be helpful, most web browsers remember a lot of information you've supplied as you've been using them. There are some things to do before you leave. Clear the history. This is almost the running joke, right? Clear my browser history when I die. This is the list of sites that you visited over time. You want to clear that when you leave the company. Clear autofill. These are the suggestions that appear when you're filling out online forms or typing things into the address bar. Clear remembered passwords. While having the browser remembered passwords for you can be a convenience, realize that your information is then available to anyone who uses that computer after you do. Clear the cache. Now, the cache is really only a speed optimization, and it makes the browser display web pages more quickly, but it also leaves a trace of which websites you visited recently. Cookies. Same thing. The cookies left on your machine by the websites you've visited amount to a record of which sites you visited. There's a strong argument that you should clear absolutely everything your browser will allow you to clear. Email will vary a lot based on which client you use, but there are definitely some things to look at. Empty any deleted mail folders that hold personal emails or information. Remove your personal mail, scan for the email in all remaining folders, and delete it. You may also want to copy items somewhere else if you want to save them for yourself. Don't forget the sent mail folder if there is one. If you've configured your email program with both your personal email account and your work-related accounts, delete your personal email account, including all of its folders and settings. Change your password. Again, this is just good practice in case you left a trace of your personal email account on the machine. And again, do this from a different machine, ideally your own at home, after you're done with your work machine. Compacting your folders is a not so obvious one, but it is something that's worth looking into. After you've deleted your personal email, compact the folders if that's an option. Messages can sometimes be recovered from uncompacted files. In the future, consider using only a web-based email reader to access your personal email on your work machine. Now, Windows gets a little bit more complicated. Spend some time reviewing what's in your documents or similar folders, including all of the subfolders therein. The Downloads folder is another example where items could be left that you've long forgotten about. Be sure to copy any files you want to, and that you have the right to, take with you. Consider running something like CCleaner, the Windows general purpose cleanup tool. It has options to delete a lot of the history, the temporary files, saved passwords, and not just for Windows and Windows programs, but for several other common applications as well. When you're leaving a work machine behind, this is a case where it actually makes sense to let CCleaner be quite aggressive. It also has a free space wiping function, which I recommend you run after you've deleted everything from your machine that you know to delete. The bottom line here, of course, is that the single most important thing you can do to protect yourself in the future is to keep your work and your private lives separate. This means never using your work computer for anything personal, and vice versa. I know it's convenient, and in many cases, it's totally safe. But unfortunately, people just don't know how unsafe it is until they've been shown the door. With the ubiquity of mobile devices these days, you've got a very pragmatic alternative right there in your pocket. Keep your personal life on your personal device. However, don't connect to workplace Wi-Fi. As I alluded to earlier, businesses may monitor the traffic flowing over networks they provide, which means that they might be able to monitor anything you do over Wi-Fi. Most workplaces don't monitor individuals, at least not without cause. Most places are safe, and most people never run into a problem. The problem is we just don't know whether we fall into that category of most until the day we leave, at which point it's too late. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/2121. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.